Good morning, dear children. Welcome back. In today's session, we are going to learn about lesson 3, rights and duties of children. Come, children, let us learn. Before going into today's session, what we are going to learn in this unit? Define citizen of a country. List the rights of children. Describe right to survival. Explain right to development. Give details about right to production and participation. Dear children, this lesson is about a conversation between a boy Ramesh and his mother. Let us see what they are discussing. In school today, Ramesh had an interesting day. He learned many rules that he must follow in class. Let us listen to him talking to his mother about his class.
Amma, today my class teacher has given us a list of rules that we all have to follow.
Amma saying, that's good.
Amma, we should not change our sheets in the middle of the class time in school as it would disturb others. Like this, there are so many rules, Amma.
Now mother is saying, I think that is very important. Rules are made so that the class can work together properly without disturbing others. You have to follow the rules set by a teacher.
I understand. Our teacher said the same.
You know, there are rules that all citizens of the country have to follow.
Citizens? What does that mean, Amma?
Citizen is a person who is a member of a country. A citizen enjoys the rules given to him or her by the country. If you member of a country, you are citizen of that country. A citizen will enjoy so many rules because he born in a particular country and living over then he has some rights.
Okay, who set these rules for citizens?
The Constitution of India set these rules. The set of rules of a country is known as constitution. Constitution means the set of rules of a country is known as constitution.
Yes, Amma. So that my teacher said if we follow these rules, we will become responsible.
Child rights. All over the world, there are different policies and rights. Children have certain rights to ensure that every child is treated the same. These are practiced to create a healthy environment for the children to live in. See what Kavya and her father talk about child's rights.
Appa, do children have any rights?
Yes, Kavya. All over the world, there are many countries which have agreed to make some basic rights for children. Our country is one of them.
Really? Appa, can you tell me more?
Sure. The four major child rights are right to survival, right to development, right to production, right to participation.
It is to ensure every child has access to minimum standards of food. This helps in healthy growth in all children. There are different rights for children below the age of 6 and between the age of 6 to 14 years. This is because both age groups have different needs for their growth and development. Dear children, the WASH program is also a part of it. Have you heard of it? WASH stands for water, sanitation and hygiene. It means there should be access to clean water for drinking and other needs. There are many diseases that spread through water. To avoid these, having access to safe water is very important.
Yes, Appa. Even my teacher told us to wash our hands before and after food.
Right to development. Every child has the right to go to school and develop life skills. Do you know that no one can stop you from getting admission in a government school?
Really? Near my house, I see some children not going to school.
Yes, you can see. But all children below 14 years have the right to go to school. The government is responsible to provide free education to all. What do you see in this picture? Children are involved in different works at different places. This is called child labor. It is illegal to force children below the age of 14 to work.
Really? What should we do if we see children working as child labor around us?
Call the child line number 1098-1098 and inform. You can call at any time and it is free of cost. If you see a child labor, talk to him first. If they are forced to do the job, you can call the number and inform. They will come and help the child. Right to protection. Children have the right to be protected in all circumstances. Indian government has set laws for the same. Raman and Kavita's mother is talking to them about the right to protect themselves. Let us hear their conversation. Can you tell me what are the different parts of your body that no one should touch?
Lips, chest, and between my legs.
Yes. To whom will you say if someone touches you in these parts?
We will tell to an elder we trust like you.
Will you be scared if someone touches you in any or all of these parts or any other part and make you feel uncomfortable?
No, Amma. I will not be scared. Yes, and I will shout at the top of my voice for help.
Dear children, there are laws to punish people who touch children inappropriately. All you need to do is keep an eye out for danger and be confident. Right to participate. Dear children have the right to participate in matters related to them. This includes asking questions, giving suggestions, and making decisions in things that affect them. Let us listen to the discussion in Vani's teacher's class. Our school is going to be renovated. We need your suggestions to improve the school. Can you all discuss and make a list?
Yes, teacher. We have the following suggestions for the school. Our school should have toilets at every floor. Drinking water facility for every four classrooms. The sports room needs more carom boards, chess boards, balls and badminton so that everyone can play.
Teacher is saying, wonderful ideas. I will send this to the headmistress.
Thank you, teacher.
Students, did you understand this class? A small recap of what we have learned in this class. Every citizen of the country can enjoy the rights and do duties. Children also have special rights. Children have the right to have healthy food for growth and development. Children have the right to go to school and have good education. Children have the right to be protected against danger. Children have the right to participate in the matters related to them. Okay, students, I hope you have understood lesson 3, rights and duties of children. Thank you.